hatching eggs is fun.
Wow, you're so handsome. What the?
But when we hatched this old clutch of eggs, we knew exactly what was inside. Now just imagine how fun it could be if it was a total surprise. Luckily, we've got these mystery eggs. Let's try and hatch them out and give them an amazing life. Should be easy, right? Wrong. It's day one and the eggs are on the brink of death.
Look at those little eggs, man.
They are rock hard and even dented, which tells me they are severely dehydrated. This doesn't surprise me one bit. I bought them from an empty enclosure at a pet store, and this enclosure had a screen top. These enclosures do not hold water very well. I'm guessing the eggs weren't exposed to enough moisture. But they can be saved if we act quickly. I'm using super hatch and distilled water as an incubation medium. I'm then using my phone flashlight to locate a potential embryo so I can orient the eggs the right side up. I think I'm seeing life in here, but only time will tell if this is gonna work. These eggs are gonna incubate in the reptibator. Whoever named that product, please give them a raise, please. And now we just need to let them cook.
I cannot believe what I'm seeing right now. Look at—
It's day 15 and I think they're gonna make it, but we're not out of the woods yet. They've almost doubled in size and the dent is totally gone. That's great. You can even see an embryo developing.
Wow.
It's that little red shadow surrounded by a ring of veins. Our efforts paid off.
Good job, Alex. Yay.
But I have to be honest with you, I've always had somewhat of an idea what's in these eggs. They aren't a bird or a future US Army soldier, they are reptilian. And I know that because they were in the reptile section. But the exact species is still a mystery to me. That is truthful. It's day 57 and my suspicions are confirmed. And now I know more than ever that these eggs should survive. You can see clear as day their little face moving inside the egg. It would be kind of embarrassing to force them to survive and not give them a good life, so let's make them a home. Two eggs means two enclosures that need to be ready before they hatch. They'll both start the same way but end totally different. That'll make more sense later. And then, oh, A. Oh, okay.
Whew.
And a nice little tropical substrate blend. They also need areas to climb. That's gonna be branches, logs, and some rocks. I could use the wood inside of Pea Alley.
Woo! Pea Alley!
But then I wouldn't have an excuse to see the largest animal that I know. This is Brooks.
Whoa!
And he's gonna help us gather materials. Here we see two adult Homo sapiens entering the forest. One is well built and strong. This seems to be the elder. The other is a bit skinnier. I sure hope he can pull his weight. Oh yeah, we're in good hands.
I gotta get a thinner rock.
Gathering your own materials for these sorts of projects is great because it's free, but be careful. Grab the wrong wood and your act of kindness could kill your beloved creatures. I like to stick to oak and maple. I want some rocks too. Luckily, I'm strong as f. I would call this a success, all this for the price of a train ticket home.
Get out of there!
That ticket was purchased by our generous supporters on Patreon. Thanks for that. Brooks will give you a big wet smooch. I'm back home and I can't help but take a peek at the eggs. They're much plumper, which means we're getting very close to a hatch. We need to get to work. We're baking the wood to kill any potential hitchhiking pests like slugs or ants. No free lunch, bozos. The goal is to make the two enclosures feel different from each other just in case our hatchlings have different personalities. Things started off a little bit rough. I have this broken enclosure that I dropped a while back, but I want to use the beautiful live planted background that's inside. The problem is though that it's glued in, you know? I have an idea though. I can break the glass to free it.
I'm closing my eyes so I don't get glass in them.
Alright, good. Try again. Okay. One more. And perfect. You can see I'm speechless, but my dumb thought this was going to break into like five big pieces and not shatter into a million glass murder snowflakes. I spent the next hour cleaning the glass out of the plants. Makes me feel like one of those little monkeys grooming bugs out of another monkey, which is nice. It gives you a nice warm and fuzzy feeling, and the effort is worth it because it looks great. For the other enclosure, we're going to stick to the wood we gathered. This massive wood fits like OJ's glove, barely, but vertical surfaces like this are key, so we need to make it work. I've got some plants in the mail that should look perfect wedged throughout the scape, like this bromeliad. This will hold some water for our creatures to drink. The other enclosure is getting some sticks too, but we're going to use plants that have a little bit of a darker aesthetic. We're going to come back later to add in some rarely seen creatures that will do an important job for us. We're back with the eggs, and I want to cut them open so bad, but I know that I shouldn't. But luckily, we didn't have to wait long. I think we finally have a hatch. My room is peaceful for a change, which is great because life outside the egg can be really terrifying for something so small. I first noticed one of the eggs was deflated, but where's the gecko?
Oh, okay. That's, yo. Yeah, dude, you're an hour old. No way. Hi, dude, you've been on Earth for an hour. Can you imagine if human babies were this agile or useful at any point before age 12?
Oh, perfect. Cuddled up on that scorching hot coil. I'm sure that's comfy.
All right, come here. I want to be very gentle with them. Okay. Hi. Oh my God, relax. Hi.
She still got those fresh baby scales. This is a beautiful and healthy crested gecko. We thought these geckos were extinct until 1994 when one landed on a research tent. And now I have one in my bedroom. I know that I forced you to be alive, but I'm really happy to have you here. I'm gonna give her some alone time and then give her a true checkup later. But what about the other egg? Well, it's taking its time. I'm trying to stimulate a hatch by rolling them, but no luck. When I wake up in a puddle of my own fluids, I'm judged for it. But when I find this the next day, we call it a miracle of life. It's funny how things work. It took 78 days for both hatchlings to make it out of their eggs. But are they healthy? I didn't even think they would live, to be honest with you. But amazingly, I am not spotting any obvious deformities, which is incredible. But they are a little bit small, a little skinny, and that slight kinking in their tails could be a sign of a calcium deficiency. We need to get them eating high protein meals. They need to learn to hunt. It's a terrible day to be a white cricket with a broken leg on black construction paper. There's also some juicy, delicious hornworms close by. That little horn looks sharp, but it's perfectly safe. And these guys make a great occasional treat. But will our geckos even like them? When the geckos are relaxed and curious, they make slow and calculated moves. You can really see them taking in their environment. Let's listen close and see if we can hear what they're thinking.
We did it, Joe.
This one has finally noticed a hornworm. It really doesn't get more disrespectful than licking your lips in front of your still alive meal. He inches closer but doesn't pounce. Maybe because the worm is so still, it's not triggering a food response. But what's this? A divine intervention? But surprisingly, no bite. But what about a cricket? This definitely seems to pique their interest a bit more. The crickets dive for cover, but curious crested geckos leave no crack unexplored. This little one is focused hard, and you can see that tiny brain working on something.
No chance. What? Why is it so big?
I'm gonna blur the poop, because I know some of you are eating. Dude. We're having a hard time getting them to eat their bugs, but I've got one more trick I can try. If you rip the cricket's head off, exposing that yummy torso juice, the geckos can rarely resist. And of course, this worked like a charm. When this trick works once, it usually works over and over again. Take notes. We may all be eating crickets just like this when our crops start failing. But before I put them in their jungle home, I need them to hunt on their own because I'm not going to be tong feeding them for their entire life.
I'm excited though.
Okay.
Oh, I see some butt. Easy access. Hi. Oh, dude, they're so cute. I'm going to try to pick out the smallest ones. These are your last moments alive.
They lose focus pretty easily, but it's hard to get mad at something so cute.
This is not what I anticipated would happen. You're shaking too.
Baby hunting is a failure. Just might not work. And that's what I thought until I saw this. That lunge is a food response to the cricket. Let's try one more time. Once the gecko's eyes lock onto its prey, that cricket is done for. He just needs to get a good bite. He inches closer, carefully tracking the cricket's movement. At the perfect moment, he strikes. He's holding his meal here for a second, squeezing his jaws tighter, speeding up the cricket's last moments. Not to be courteous, just out of instinct. And when those jaws sink into that delicious micro meat, they do not let go. I can only imagine how weird of a sensation it is to swallow this. Like taking down a rotisserie chicken on a string. That stray antenna is the only piece still not gone, but he's quick to clear it away, always finishing off his meal with a nice lick. The hatchlings are ready to go into their new home, but we need to make some finishing touches. We still need to add in three creatures that are vital for a healthy functioning ecosystem. First up, some zebra isopods. These guys will eat any plants that die back. Next up, some beautiful orange springtails. These guys are gorgeous and very tiny. Here's me next to one for scale. I get them out of their culture by using their favorite food, mushrooms. These guys will eat mold and fungi. Look at that jackpot underneath. And now we play God just one more time as we transport them into their new home. Our last creature is one you don't see used enough in the hobby. This is a buffalo beetle. They're not very good on their back. They get a bit panicky, but they're incredibly helpful because they eat the dead. Any crickets that go uneaten will likely die and be cleaned up by this crew. They'll eat decomposing plant matter too if they have to, but I've definitely found they prefer protein. And just as we're about to add in our lucky geckos, a rainstorm is moving in. It's really raining. It's not me flickering a light. Isn't nature beautiful? Everything came together super well. These geckos went from a clump of cells just hours away from death to two healthy geckos. Welcome to the world. Sorry. They do seem to love their little jungle oasis. These will eventually be put up for free for adoption on Patreon, so make sure to check out our page for updates, behind the scenes, and other deleted content. The link is in the description. If you liked this video, check out this one. And if you really liked it, send it to your mom.
Okay, thanks.
Bye.